Okay, we are back again for the weekly Bitcoin roundup. This time, a lot of people in Japan already know her. Her name is Miss Bitcoin Mai Fujimoto.
Hi.
Yes, hello. So you've seen her in some other videos probably. She's pretty well known within the Japanese Bitcoin community. Maybe not as well known outside of Japan yet, but that's going to change, and we're going to get to know a little bit more about her today. So why don't you tell us a little bit more about yourself and how you became interested in Bitcoin real quick.
Okay. So we met in 2011, right?
That's right.
And so you teach me about Bitcoin. And so I tried to create donation platform, but you know, fiat is very expensive. And then you teach me about Bitcoin, and Bitcoin is very cheap and almost no fee. And I can donate to children so directly. So it is very amazing. So, because why I interested in Bitcoin. And in these 6 years, so I'm always exciting about Bitcoin because it grow very fast. And so, yeah, 6 years ago, everyone said us scammer because Bitcoin concept is very difficult to understand. So, but now, so many people, people know about Bitcoin, and it is very, I'm very happy to, this situation.
Yeah, and time goes very fast, and for a lot of people that don't know, when I first met Mai, she couldn't speak any English at all. So, and obviously she still has a little bit of an accent at the moment, but her English is fantastic compared to when I first met her. She could barely speak three words, and now she can have whole conversations in English now. So,
thank you.
Yeah, thank you. So, here we are coming up on, 6 or 7 years after we first met. Mm-hmm. And we're here, and I have a list of things that I put together to talk about. It's kind of the week in review about what's happening in Bitcoin. And when I say Bitcoin, of course, I'm referring to Bitcoin Cash because it's the one that behaved in the same way Bitcoin behaved when we first met and I first told you about it in, I think, December of 2011 or 2012. So.
2011.
Time flies. So, of course, one of the big topics for this week is Bitcoin Cash is having an upgrade on May 15th, where the maximum block size is going to increase from 8 megabytes to 15 megabytes. I'm sorry, 32 megabytes, which is going to enable more than 100 transactions per second on chain, just like that. That's a lot of transactions on chain every second. So, any thoughts on that?
So, for payment, so you know, I have donation platform, and for me, it is very important to send easy and cheaper and just very faster. Mm-hmm. It's very important for me. And I know maybe Bitcoin Core also development of the Bitcoin beta. But right now, so for me, very useful Bitcoin Cash for donate.
Why don't you tell everybody the URL for your website? So any Bitcoin Cash fans out there, if they want to, they can send some money your way. What's the domain name for your website?
Kizuna.com.
So KIZUNA.com?
Yes. Kizuna means help in Japanese, help each other and relationship and bond. Yeah.
And right now your website supports both Bitcoin Core and Bitcoin Cash, is that right?
Yes.
Which one do you have more donations in recently?
So recently, so I'm not so much promotion, and now almost both zero. And so I want to share about Kizuna donation platform, and I want to know which currency, which Bitcoin is more and get money, get donation. Yeah, I'm very curious.
I'm very curious. Have you considered accepting Lightning Network donations on your website?
I considered before. I talked about with my friend, development Lightning Network. But some point is very difficult to open channel, close channel. And if, send money a lot, this relationship is very work for, Lightning Network. But donation is sometimes, not many times. So, open channel and closed channel is complicated for.
So you're saying that the setup for Lightning Network was too complicated to make it worth your time to set up on your website?
Right now, so yeah, for everyone, so I think it is difficult way, not easy for everyone. Sorry, dude.
I understand and I agree. She says Lightning Network is not easy for people. It's difficult to use right now.
I think so.
So another thing that I have on my list of things to discuss here was Mike Hearn, 3 years ago this week, wrote an essay on Medium called Crash Landing, What Not to Do. And he was talking about the blocks becoming full on the Bitcoin network and all the bad things that would happen if the blocks became full. And he was writing this 3 years ago this week. And now that we have 3 years of time has gone by, we can look back on what he wrote and we can look back on what happened. And he was exactly right when he described all the problems that would happen to the Bitcoin network if the blocks were allowed to become full. And a lot of people that are new to Bitcoin probably have no idea who Mike Hearn was. Mike Hearn was one of the very first developers to start getting involved in Bitcoin and was corresponding directly with Satoshi and with Gavin and these other people. And before he was involved in Bitcoin full-time, he was a professional capacity planner at Google. Google is one of the most popular websites in the entire world, so he's in charge of planning capacity for Google. Obviously a very, very important role to play for a company as important as Google. You have to be incredibly qualified and competent to be in such a role. And he was warning us about planning for the future capacity of Bitcoin, so I would really implore anybody out there to go and read that essay. It's easier for native English speakers to read it, but maybe it would be good English practice for you to read this essay by Mike Hearn, who is a great guy. Mm. Had you heard of Mike Hearn before?
So he?
Yeah.
So his name is very popular. Everyone knows Mike Hearn, but I haven't met him.
Yeah.
But a few months ago, he visited in Japan, right?
If he did, I didn't hear about that. So, but he did do an Ask Me Anything on Reddit a few weeks ago as well. Mm-hmm. That was great. So that brings me to the next item on my list here, which I think is really, really, really big news. So, and I have to admit, I had never heard of WeCall app before, and I'm guessing you had not heard of WeCall app before?
I don't know this.
So, and I hadn't heard of it either, but I was just looking at it before we started recording on the Google Play Store. It says that they have more than 10 million installs on Android, and their website and their press release claims that they have more than 33 million installs. They already have more than 33 million installs, whereas by comparison, our Bitcoin.com wallet only has about 2.3 million wallets created on our platform. So they have, you know, more than 10 times as much. And they've announced that they're integrating Bitcoin Cash into all of their apps there. Like, that's a really, really big deal. So more than 33 million additional people are going to have Bitcoin Cash apps in there. And I think it's really telling that this happened on top of Bitcoin Cash. It didn't happen on top of Bitcoin Core, because if you want people to use it as payments, Bitcoin Core doesn't work, whereas Bitcoin Cash works just like the Bitcoin that I first gave you and set you up that first night when I met you so many years ago. And what are your thoughts about one single app with 33 million people using it, installing, giving it all their users Bitcoin Cash wallets? Any thoughts?
難しい。
意味わかった?
意味が難しい。
I'll ask her in Japanese to help out a little bit. Sorry. このアプリは330万以上インストールされている。それ全員 Bitcoin Cash のサイトになる。どう思いますか? What do you think?
Yeah, very, very, a lot.
A lot of things happening on Bitcoin Cash.
Yeah.
That brings us to two other ones that I think are pretty interesting. So there's Memo.cash and blockpress.com are basically competitors to Twitter, but each and every comment and tweet and like is recorded right there in the Bitcoin Cash blockchain. And recently in the media, we've been hearing about a lot of censorship happening on Twitter and that sort of thing. Have you been hearing about that in Japan? Is that news in Japan also?
So, no, but today I know this service, but I didn't know.
And did you hear about...
But recently, so blockchain-based media or SNS services, there are many.
Another really, really interesting thing, I think, is that the Bitcoin Cash price has been rising much faster than the Bitcoin Core price this last week. Have you noticed that?
Yeah, I'm surprised. So, what's happened?
I think because of the adoption and things being built on top of Bitcoin Cash, I think people are very bullish on the future of Bitcoin Cash. Mm-hmm. And there's not really anything exciting happening on Bitcoin Core any longer. So, and there was another on my list here, another thing that I have here is that the censorship in our Bitcoin is continuing. There was another post talking about where they gave an actual screenshot where somebody made a very reasonable comment about what was happening, and they were banned from our Bitcoin simply for making a reasonable comment. So, like, the censorship should be absolutely unacceptable to the Bitcoin community, yet it is still going on in full swing today on our Bitcoin. Censorship is still happening. So, any thoughts on the censorship going on by Bitcoin Core supporters that are running our Bitcoin on Reddit?
So, I knew about censorship. So, from you, but I don't know about the censorship, but.
I think Vitalik told you about the censorship also, right?
Yeah, Vitalik. Yeah. Yes. And so now still have, censorship program.
Yeah. What do you think about people using censorship in the Bitcoin community?
It's not good.
Another piece of news actually that I saw this week. So some Bitcoin Core supporters went to a Bitcoin Cash meetup and were given Bitcoin Cash stickers and t-shirts, and everybody at the Bitcoin Cash meetup was very friendly towards them.
Oh.
And then they went home that night with the shirts and stickers that they received at the Bitcoin Cash meetup. Do you know what they did with them?
So yeah, I know. So I surprised some Bitcoin Core people wearing your t-shirts and post it on his Twitter, right?
Maybe I missed that, but also what happened is some Bitcoin Core supporters went to a Bitcoin Cash meetup and they received shirts and Bitcoin Cash stickers and they went home and lit them on fire and took a video of burning the shirts and the stickers.
Wow, so sad.
What?
I don't like I didn't know that. I thought Bitcoin Cash and Bitcoin Core have had a great time. I thought because I saw Twitter and the Bitcoin Core's people wear the Bitcoin Cash t-shirt, but I don't like this. 何? 強いの? I don't like the kind of mean. 何て言うの? I don't know how can I say, but very sad.
So, if you don't like Bitcoin Cash, that's fine. Don't use it. But you don't need to ask for free stickers and shirts and then light them on fire. So.
Don't worry. I have many stickers. I'm not.
I think she has several kilograms of our Bitcoin Cash stickers at this point.
In my house.
And don't worry. We will give you a lot more today before you go home.
I don't need any more.
Yeah. So, Makoto, can you grab one of the bricks here? We'll give it to her right now.
No. So. I don't.
And not only stickers, but here, I have this waiting here for you.
Oh, thank you.
We have a wonderful Bitcoin Cash shirt we'll give you.
Oh, thank you.
And here's a whole brick of Bitcoin.com stickers. I don't know if you have this type yet. Do you have this type?
I already have.
Okay, well, now you have even more.
Too heavy,
you know. You don't run out. This is 1 kilogram. And here's a shirt. I think
I love this.
I think this shirt would look a lot better than that shirt.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you.
Are you willing to put this one on, maybe? We'll finish the interview wearing this shirt.
Now?
Turn around for everybody so they can see
your
shirt. Yeah, what's it say on the back of your shirt? Let me see. You gotta move your hair so everybody can see. Turn around. Oh, Bitcoin.com.
Bitcoin.com?
Do you like this website?
Yeah.
Yeah, you visit it often?
Sometimes.
I'm not sure if I agree. Sometimes. So, but we're coming out with a Japanese version soon.
Yes.
Yeah.
Sometimes.
So. Another thing, though, is that, MMA, professional female fighter, Mei Yamaguchi, Japanese girl, Bitcoin.com sponsored her for her title match coming up in Singapore in next week.
Oh, you sponsored it?
Yeah. Yeah. Cool. How about you? Do you like MMA?
MMA?
Do you know MMA? Sogo Kaktogi.
I will try.
You will try?
I will try.
Okay. Maybe Mei can teach you some moves after she comes back from Singapore. And so I guess that's kind of the end of the things on my list for this week. Any things you want to talk about? The exciting news that happened in the world of Bitcoin Cash this week?
So
tell us things from Japan. Any news from Japan?
Japan? So, Bitcoin Cash News.
Yeah.
So I went to Israel last week.
Yep.
And I met Ken Shishido.
Yep.
Ken Shishido is a famous Bitcoin Tokyo Bitcoin Meetup organizer. Also, he is a support Bitcoin Cash, and so always he talk about Bitcoin Cash in Israel. So I got a 24 presentation from blockchain companies, and so Ken together, and Ken always ask, how about Bitcoin Cash, and what do you think about Bitcoin Cash? And yeah, it and was very
yeah. When I set up the Bitcoin Cash meetup group here in Tokyo back in 2011. Shishido Ken was one of the very first people to come, and he came religiously every single week. He was always there to this very day, and he's still totally active, supporting the vision of Bitcoin that we had from day one, which was a peer-to-peer electronic cash system for the world, meaning fast, cheap, reliable transactions, and that's Bitcoin Cash today. So we're really glad to have Ken around. Thank you, Ken, if you watch this video. Any other news from Japan? Or
it's
Israel?
Okay, my news.
Yeah, tell us your news, that's fine.
So, I mentioned before, I have a donation platform. And so now.
So this is kizuna.world, not .com. So K-I-Z-U-N-A.
Kizuna.world.
Yeah, not .com. So that's a very important distinction. Yeah. K-I-Z-U-N-A.world is her website if you want to make some Bitcoin Cash donations
This is now Bitcoin Cash.
Yeah, here it is, Bitcoin Cash.
Yeah. And so.
And it looks like you're using the legacy Bitcoin Cash address format. You should update to the Bitcoin Cash address format so people don't accidentally send Bitcoin Cash to Bitcoin Core addresses or Bitcoin Core to Bitcoin Cash addresses.
But I think from exchanges, maybe if this address.
So you should tell the exchanges to update to the Bitcoin Cash
okay.
format.
So. Okay, yeah. So, and so I, this is education for children. So they made a education program for all of the world. It is very good concept. And so they need a donation. And I'm very happy if you donate this NPO.
This website is Japanese only or is there English?
Now Japanese only, but will.
Even if you don't speak Japanese, it'll be easy to find the donation address on the website. So visit Kizuna, KIZUNA.world.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
And that's it. So if you like our weekly update videos, I would ask you to like our video on YouTube, comment on it, and subscribe to our channel, and then share it on social media. That's the only way we have of getting the word out. So it actually makes a big difference in YouTube's algorithms as to which videos it shows to more people. So please like, comment, and subscribe on the video. Every YouTuber says that at the end of the video because it actually does help. So it's not just something to say. They say it because it actually works and helps to spread the video. So please like, comment, and subscribe, and then share on social media our video. And stay tuned for our next video and tell your friends. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.